and welcome to the weekend edition of Up South, where we get you what was making news in South India during the week and the special stories put out by a team of reporters. The collapse of an under-construction building yesterday, in which 61 people who were working on the site were killed, left the country shocked. The builder was quick to blame the elements for the tragedy. Headlines today investigation revealed that not everything was hunky-dory about the manner in which the building was being constructed and why Chennai, like many other cities in India, isn't exactly a safe city.
Preliminary investigations have revealed a number of factors that may have contributed to the collapse of this particular building, and the foundation that was dug up for the construction of these stilts and the rafts slabs were not strong enough. This is what the experts said when they were digging out the rubble.
See, this is the soil that, you know, where the building has been built upon, which according to the experts and the reports say that it is not fit for building a 11-storied residential complex.
On Saturday evening, when the heavens opened to pound heavy rainfall on Chennai, it took less than a minute for this 11-storied under-construction building on the outskirts of the city to convert into 8,000 metric tons of rubble. The builders were quick to blame the elements, claiming that a cloudburst, which is capable of increasing the temperature from 30 degrees Celsius to 20,000 degrees Celsius, had brought down the structure. However, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jayalalitha was not buying the excuse.
It appears that the building plans that were approved cannot strictly adhere to by the builders. There was nothing wrong with the plans that were submitted for approval, but the builders knowingly committed many violations and did not adhere to the plans that were approved.
But this may not be the only building in Chennai that could come down crumbling like a pack of cards, especially those whose foundations are not on firm ground, literally. In this particular case, Prime Srishti had started the ambitious 12-plus-1-storied building in a low-lying area like Mohali Vakkam, which was once a lake area. The sand is loose, making the foundation weak. The nearby buildings were not high-rise like this one.
The place in which they were built is unfit for a multi-storey building, that means 11-storey building. Number two, it does not have enough road width to justify a 11-storey building, which is quite high. Number three, they have manipulated the FSA norms, set forward norms in order to give a bigger building on 1 acre of land.
In 2006, a monitoring committee in which Deva Sahayam is a member was formed to check on the illegal constructions in the city. But the committee got no cooperation from the government. With Chennai, Kanchipuram and Chengalpet areas witnessing a construction boom, developers are only tempted to cut corners.
Attitude I find is, no, people want to buy, can I get lower than this price? Can I get a lower price? Can I get a lower price? So there is an urgency for them to pull the prices down. It's natural. But what happens? Even in government contracts, yes, you follow the lowest tender, but then there is a technical bid and then a price bid. So the quality is first is segregated. Only among the quality you must be able to price. So when the price is at a low point, people should now ask this question, how is it possible to give at that price?
There are 12,700 builders in Tamil Nadu. According to an estimate, there are violations in at least 14,000 buildings in Chennai. On a multi-storied building, PWD fire officials should regularly monitor. It is hardly done. Since most of the quarries are shut, it's the sand mafia which controls the sand production. Many builders use M-sand, which is of low quality and cannot bind the sand together for a long time. Similarly, to save money, builders use fly ash. Both fly ash and M-sand can be used, but in a proper quantity. In some areas like OMR on outskirts of Chennai, there's no sewage connection and electricity board connection.
What the building collapse on Saturday has exposed that many of these castles are perhaps are being built in air. For all those who worked on the site as well as those who invested in it, it has been anything but a home sweet home. Priyambada in Chennai for Headlines Today.